Today, I'm going to share some cool command line tools which you can use in Linux terminal. If you have been using Linux for a while, you might already be familiar with all or most of the commands that I'm going to mention here today. But if you're a new Linux user, it might drastically increase your command line performance. The commands that I'm going to talk today are based on bash shell, and you can find your shell type by using echo shell command. Even though these are standard Linux commands, depending on the shell type you're using, it might or might not work the exact same way it's working on my terminal. But if you're using bash shell, it should behave the same way no matter which Linux distro you're using. A while ago, I had published one video where I discussed 11 basic Linux commands for beginner users. But today I'm going to talk about those commands which I frequently use and have increased my command line efficiency by many folds over the years. So the first command, and I think every Linux user knows this, is autocompletion. So whether it's a command or a file name, when you type a few letters and hit tab, it'll try to autocomplete the rest of the commands or file name, as long as it is unique in that directory. So let's see. So we have three directories that starts with letter D, and Linux is case sensitive, so you have to type the exact way it is written here. So uppercase D, you have to type uppercase. If it's a lowercase d, you have to type lowercase d. So if you want to change the directory, which is cd command, change directory and space, and if you tab without typing anything, it will give you all the directories under that current directory. And any directory with the dot in front of it or the file, it's a hidden file. So you don't see that, just do by ls. If you want to see them all, you have to do ls hyphen a. But let's talk about that autocompletion. So if you want to change directory, cd space lowercase d and hit tab, it doesn't do anything because there is no directory or file that starts with lowercase d. But if you type uppercase D and hit tab, now it will display three options. So you have desktops, documents, and downloads. When I said unique on that directory, meaning if you want to do auto completion, you have to make that command or file name unique. So if I do DE and then now tab, it'll automatically complete the desktop. So DE is unique. If I do DO and hit tab, it will show me documents and downloads. Now, if you do W, it'll auto complete downloads. And if you do C, it will autocomplete documents. So this is the autocomplete feature in bash shell. And you can do so when you're reading file or changing directory. If you want to read file, autocomplete and release. So this is the file name and cat is to read the file. So this is how the autocomplete saves a lot of times. And sometimes you don't know the rest of the command, but autocomplete helps a lot. Okay, so this is the first and I think one of the favorite feature of all Linux users. And our next command or tip is you can execute multiple commands with semicolon. For example, you can make directory using mkdir command, and you can make directory test use semicolon, and then you can go inside that directory using a single line. So first make a directory test semicolon and then change to that directory. So you are inside home, umis, and test directory. So by using semicolon, you can execute multiple commands. When we're talking about cd command, change directory command, let me show you something real quick. If you do cd and tilde sign, it will automatically take you to your home directory, no matter where you are. Let's say you are here. But if you do cd tilde sign, you will be in the home directory. And if you do cd space hyphen, it'll take back to last directory you were in. So /etc/systemd and cd hyphen, now your home directory again. And you can do cd tilde sign, my home directory, and under my home directory, I can go to download. And the third trick is something to do with the history command. So any command you type ls or change directory, anything you type on the shell, it is recorded in history. And if you want to see those history, you can simply type history command, or it is also recorded in your home directory and hidden bash history file. So if you want to read all the history, you can read that file as well. So let's say you type something. You want to see etc SATA file, but as a normal user, the permission is denied. So instead of typing all that command again with the sudo, you can simply type sudo space double exclamation, and it will run the last command and add sudo in front of the command. So we're asking for the password. There you go. So double exclamation simply repeats the last command. So if I do clear ls and double exclamation, it will repeat the ls. And you can see the command that it repeated here. So it's really handy. Sometimes you might be looking some information inside any file and you do not type sudo. You can do up arrow and then go up here and do sudo. But instead of that, you can just do sudo. Now it will exit the clear. You can do sudo double exclamation and run the same command again. And if you want to run any specific command that was recorded in history, let's say run this command, which is recorded in history and the history number is 21, you can do exclamation and 21, which is the history number for that command, and it will execute that command. So you can use exclamation and history number. If you do 84, which is for clear, it will clear the screen. It's really handy. And our fourth trick is also related to the history. For example, so now you can repeat the command with exclamation, double exclamation, or go to a specific history by using exclamation and number. But if you do not want to do that and search the history, you can press Control R and start typing any string that was in that line of the command. Let's say shadow. And it will search from the end of the history. And whatever the first it will find from the bottom, it will display that command. And if this is the command that you want to enter, then just hit enter. Or you type shadow and it will display that. But if you want to keep looking further towards the top, then you can press Control R while the result is being displayed. Let's just say DOW. It will display that command, Control R, next command with the shadow in it, Control R, another one, Control R, another one, Control R. So it will keep going until the end and hit enter if that's the command that you want to execute. Permission denied, sudo exclamation. So Control R is a recursive search for the history command. And the fifth trick is moving cursor on the command line. If you wanted to type some command, let's do cat etc shadow. So here you wanted to type cat, but you typed CAD. So it was a spelling mistake. So instead of going through this by using left and right arrow key, and if you're at the end of the command, you can simply type Control A to go to the beginning of the command line and just do that. And if you want to go to the end, Control E. So Control A for the beginning and Control E for the end of the command line. It will be very handy when you're typing a long command and want to jump to the front of the command line or the end of the command line. Our sixth command or trick is related to the cat command. So you know that cat command is concatenate and it reads the text or string inside the file, but you can also use this to create a file. So let's do cat and greater than sign, test file, enter. This is test, is test line, test file. And now when you want to save this file, hit enter. And when the cursor is on the blank line, then Control D, it will save that file. And if you do cat test file, then it will read the content of that file. And you can also use cat command to append something on already existing files. So if you do cat test2, this is test2 file, enter, Control D, save that file. And now if you do cat test2 again, hit enter, this is test. Just that and save. Now if you read that test2 file, then you will see that line is overwritten by the second line. The first line, this is overwritten by the second line. So if you want to append the line in already existing file, you have to use double greater than sign, test2. This is second test line, Control D, and let's read that file again. It should have two test lines. There you go. So this is test is our first line, and this is the second test line is what we appended using double greater than sign. It's very handy tool. We call this output redirection tool, greater than sign. So anything you write, echo, hello, display hello. But if you want to redirect that output to a file, then you just give that greater than sign, hello.txt. So nothing is written on the screen because this output hello was redirected to this file, hello.txt. If you do ls, it created that file, hello.txt. And if you read that file, you will see that hello. So this sign, greater than sign, is used to redirect any output to a file. And our seventh trick is something to do with output redirection. So let's say you have a big file, 30 MB, 40 MB file, and you want to delete all the contents of that file. So what you can simply do is greater than sign and that file name. So we didn't type anything, just redirected the output to the file, meaning there was nothing. So it was empty. So it will delete the content of the file and make the file empty. So if we do hello text now, nothing is there. Let's do one more test. Let's write to that file. Okay, control D, cat hello, all those random lines. And if you want to delete everything at once, simply greater than sign and hello.txt, file is empty now. This is very handy if you're trying to delete the log instead of deleting the files. If you want to empty the content of the file, you can simply do output redirection and name of the file. And the eighth trick is probably one of my favorite tool, grep. So we can use grep to filter the content of the file. I think I created one file, test file. So on this test file, there are multiple lines that has a word test, but if you want to display any specific line, you can use grep command. So cat test file, and then space pipeline and grep command. And next will be the word that you want to filter. If you do line, it will simply display the line that has the word lion. And if you do test file, grep test, since there are multiple lines with the test, it will display all the lines that has a word test. And if you want to mask multiple strings continuous, then inside the code test file, so display only one line, the last line that has a test file in it. And let's say you have multiple lines with the test, but you want a line that has a test at the end. So what you can do is cat test file grep. So you do test and dollar sign at the end. So it will try to search all the lines that has the word test, but the test is at the end of the line. So two lines. And how about if you want to find the line that has the test on the front of the line? So you can simply do test caret sign, which you can find on the number 6 on your keyboard. So it will display any line that has a test in the beginning of the line. So grep tool is very handy. For example, you want to read etc passwd file, but you want information about root only. Or user omits. The ninth trick is something to do with very familiar command, make directory. So you can use make directory to create empty directory to number 1. You can also do make directory 2 space 3 space 4 space 5. So it will create multiple directories at once. So 2, 3, 4, and 5. But you can also use mkdir to create nested directories, but with some kind of structure. And for that, mkdir space hyphen p, p for create a parent directory if it doesn't exist. And let's give it a name, recursive. That's the name of the first directory, parent directory. And inside recursive, we want to do multiple folders, but the name of the folders should be something in pattern. For example, test 1, test 2, test 3, test 4, and test 7. So what you can do is test and then use curly braces and then do 1, comma, 2, comma, 3, comma, 4, comma, 5, and so on. So if you do this and hit enter, what it does is it will create first parent directory named recursive, if it doesn't exist. And then inside recursive, it will create a directory with the name test 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So we can find the directory recursive. And if you go inside that directory, you will see the directory name test 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Very handy tool. So you can use this tool to create a nested directory inside the directories. Like for example, so inside recursive, let's create another directory called test. And inside test, let's create 21. And inside one, I want to create directory 4, comma 2. So what this will do is create a test directory first. And inside test directory, it will create directory 21 and 2. But inside 21, it will create another directory called 4. So cd test 21 and 22. But if you go inside 21, you will see directory 4. And if you go inside directory 22, there's nothing. Really cool feature. And the last command is apropos. The literal English meaning of this command is regard to or reference to. So this command will find any command or tools that you do not know the exact spelling, but you know what it does. For example, if you do apropos and directory, So it will display all the commands that has something to do with the word directory. You can do apropos, let's do encryption, or search, and then you can use the command to fulfill your task. Very handy tool, especially when you are trying to do something but you do not know the command, exact command. And if it doesn't work on your computer, you can use manDB to update the manual database. And after the update is finished, the command should work for you. So these were a few tricks that I can think of at the moment. And if I find other cool tool or commands, I'll compile them into a separate video. If you know any other cool tricks or commands for Linux command line, please share them with us in the comment box. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video and take care.